فؤادك الأيام فتى.
الشرح الشيخ ابن عثيمين شرحناه. قوله the statement of the Sheikh إن من تمام الاجتماع السمع والطاعة. That from the completeness of unity is to hear and to obey, and to the ending of that word, or the paragraph that we explained from Sheikh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen is now going to explain it. He said, ذَكَرَ الْمُؤَلِّفُ, the author mentioned, رَحِمَهُ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, may Allah have mercy upon him, أَنَّ مِنْ تَمَامِ الْإِجْتِمَاعِ, that from the completeness of unity is السَّمْعَ, to listen, وَالطَّاعَ, to obey, لِوُلَاتِ الْأَمْرِ, the Muslim leader, بِامْتِثَالِ مَا أَمَرُوا بِهِ, by following that which he orders you to do, وَتَرْكِ مَا نَهُ عَنْهُ, and to stay away from that which he prohibits you from, وَلَوْ كَانَ, even if he is, مَنْ تَأَمَّرَ عَلَيْنَا عَبْدًا حَبَشِيًّا, even if he's a slave who's an Abyssinian. قَوْلُهُ, the statement of the author, Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahab, فَبَيَّنَ اللَّهُ هَذَا بَيَانًا شَافِيًا كَافِيًا أَمَا شَائِعًا شَائِعًا كَافِيًا, the Shaykh said he means أَمَّا بَيَانُهُ شَرْعًا, the legislational clarity, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen said, is فَفِي كِتَابِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى وَسُنَّةِ رَسُولِهِ, it is that which is in the book of Allah and the sunnah of the messenger. So now he's going to give us the evidences in the kitab and the evidences which are in the sunnah pertaining to this issue. From the kitab, Allah ordering us to listen and obey our leaders is قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen, he says the speech of Allah, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا, those of you who believe, أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ, obey Allah, وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ, and obey the messenger, وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ, and those who have authority over you. الآية, the verse. It is the 59th ayah in Surah An-Nisa. So, Allah تبارك وتعالى, he ordered us to follow who? Allah تبارك وتعالى, he ordered us, subhanahu wa ta'ala, to follow him, to obey him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah ordered us to obey him. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala ordered us to obey who? The messenger. Without what? Without any condition. Allah and his messenger, or their obedience are without a condition. بِدُونِ قَيْدٍ وَلَا شَرْطٍ, there's no condition stipulated to it. Are you with me? We obey Allah and his messenger unrestrictedly. Allah and his messenger, we obey them unrestrictedly because they are infallible. Everything that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us, there will be no mistakes in it. Everything that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells us, there will be no mistakes in it. Are you with me? Very good. And that is why Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he repeated the verb twice. Are you with me? For the Prophet. Pay attention, look at the ayah. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, those of you who believe, ati'u Allah, obey Allah, wa ati'u Rasul, and obey the messenger. But he didn't say, wa ati'u ulil amri minkum, and obey. Allah just said, and the people who have authority over you. Why did Allah tabarak wa ta'ala bring the verb twice for himself, subhanahu wa ta'ala, and for the Prophet? Because those two, their obedience is what? Unrestricted. بدون قيد ولا شرط. But the leader, his obedience is if it is in accordance to what? His obedience is in if it's in accordance to the obedience of Allah and his messenger. So if he tells you, to do that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala prohibited, you don't obey him on it. But he still doesn't lose the overall obedience. You just disobey him in that particular matter. And you say to him, I can't do this. Are you with me? I can't obey you in this sin, and I am not allowed to do it. But if he tells you to do something else which is permissible, you obey him and you have to listen to him. You see, that is the wisdom in the ayah. وَقَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى, and the statement of Allah, وَأَطِيعُ اللَّهَ, obey Allah, وَرَسُولَهُ, and his messenger, وَلَا تَنَازَعُوا, do not dispute one another, فَتَفْشَلُوا, and so you lose, وَتَذْهَبَ رِيحُكُمْ, and your strength goes. وَاصْبِرُوا, be patient. إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ, Allah is with those who are patient. Good. وَقَوْلُ, so the inner ayah, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, what did he say to us? In that verse, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he tells us what? That us disputing one another and breaking up is a path for weakness. It's a road to weakness. So we don't dispute one another. We were ordered to be patient with our leaders. We don't dispute with them when we do not argue with them. The ayah, it falls under that. And that's why the Sheikh brought it, Ibn Uthaymeen. وَقَوْلُهُ And also the statement of Allah, وَعَتَصِمُوا بِحَبْلِ اللَّهِ جَمِيعًا وَلَا تَفَرَّقُوا Hold on to the rope of Allah together and do not dispute one another. Don't dispute your leader. Don't go against him. Stay with him. That it falls under the ayah in Surah Ali Imran. Very good. So that's from the Kitab of Allah. The Sunnah is left now. وَمِن بَيَانِهِ فِي سُنَّةَ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ Also the clarity which is in the Sunnah of the Messenger is مَا ثَبَتَ فِي الصَّحِيحَيْنِ مِنْ حَدِيثُ عُبَادَةَ بْنُ صَامِتٍ It is that which has been transmitted in Sahih al-Bukhari and Bukhari and Muslim. In Sahih al-Bukhari and in Sahih Muslim, which are the two most authentic books after the Book of Allah. That عُبَادَةَ بْنُ صَامِتٍ رضي الله تعالى عنه said بَايَعْنَا رَسُولُ اللَّهِ The messenger, he took a pledge of allegiance with us. Bay'ah is a pledge of allegiance. Look what the Prophet took pledge of allegiance with the companions on. What was it? عَلَى السَّمْعِ To listen. وَالطَّاعَةِ And to obey. He told them, عليه الصلاة والسلام, what? To obey. When lacking? When they're in times of ease and joy? لا, both times. فِنْ مَنْشَطِنَا وَمَكْرَهِنَا At times on when we're enthusiastic. And at times of hardship. وَعُسْرِنَا وَيُسْرِنَا And when it's hard and when it's easy, we obey. We obey the leader in those situations. Very good. وَأَثَرَةٍ عَلَيْنَا وَأَلَّا نُنَازِعَ الْأَمْرَ أَهْلَهُ And that we do not dispute with the people who have the matter in their hands, who are the leaders. We don't dispute with them. We're not allowed to go against them. We're not allowed to go against our rulers. We are not allowed to uprise against them. This is not from that which Allah and His Messenger have permitted. Because the Prophet said what? وَأَلَّا نُنَازِعَ الْأَمْرَ And that we do not dispute the people who have authority. We don't. But we're allowed to win. The Prophet said, إِلَّا أَن تَارَوْا Until you see. كُفْرًا Disbelief. بَوَاحًا Clear cut. عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِيهِ بُرْهَانٌ Look how many conditions the Prophet stipulated to this. First of all, it has to be kufr. Pay attention. You are allowed to go against him when he comes with clear-cut what? When he comes with clear-cut kufr. Are you with me? Brothers, he has to come with clear. The kufr can't be a kufr which is photoshopped or you saw it on YouTube. It has to be clear-cut kufr. Has no other interpretation. It is crystal clear that he came with kufr. Something you saw over the internet or somebody sent you a picture or something. Where is that clear cut? Nowadays technology, people think can be photoshopped. Videos can be made. It has to be clear cut. The Prophet is saying to you, Bawah. Is that it? No. عندكم من الله في برهان. You have a evidence and a proof in the eyes of Allah the Day of Judgment. You can bring a proof forward to Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala in this point. You're able to. You see? That is very serious. Going against the ruler isn't enough to say, oh, a matter which the scholars differed on, whether it's kufr or not, you're not allowed to go against him. It's not kufr bawah. It's not clear-cut kufr. It's not clear-cut kufr. وَقَالَ عَلَيْهِ الصَّلَاةُ وَالسَّلَامُ And the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, صلوات الله وسلامه عليه. Now, before I mention the other hadith, I have to explain that hadith that I just mentioned on the commentary of Imam Nawawi rahimahullah in Sharh Sahih Muslim. He explained this hadith of Ubadah ibn Samit very well. Pay attention, and I want you to understand this. It's very important. I'm going to read his speech on here. It's on you guys. Al Imam Nawawi. Abu Zakariya Nawawi, Imam Nawawi, Sahib Riyad al-Salihin, 40 al-Nawawi, he has a sharah on what? Muslim, Sahih Muslim. He explained that hadith. Imam Nawawi said, "Ma'na al-hadith, the meaning that is in the hadith is what? La tunazi'u wulat al-umuri. Do not dispute with the people of authority. Fi wilayatihim in their leadership. Don't dispute with them. Wa la ta'taridu alayhim. And don't oppose them. إلا أن تروا unless you see كفرا منهم unless you see disbelief from them منكرا evil كفر محققا and that it's real and it's literal, which you're definite and you have unwavering conviction that he came with it. تَعْلَمُونَهُ, which you know. مِنْ قَوَاعِدِ الْإِسْلَامِ, you know it from the fundamental principles of the religion. فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمْ ذَلِكَ, if you see it. The hadith didn't say if you hear it. إِلَّا أَنْ تَرَوْا, it said see, right? You have to see with your eyes. فَإِذَا رَأَيْتُمْ ذَلِكَ, if you see that. فَأَنْكِرُوا عَلَيْهِمْ, reject that from them. وَقُولُوا بِالْحَقِّ, say the truth to them. حَيْثُمَا كُنْتُمْ, wherever you are. وَأَمَّا الْخُرُوجَ عَلَيْهِمْ, but as for to go against them. As for to what? As for to go against them. وَقِتَالُهُمْ, and to fight against them. فَحَرَامٌ, it is haram بِإِجْمَاعِ الْمُسْلِمِينَ. It is haram for you to what? To go against them. And to fight with them. It is haram by in consensus of the Muslimin. There's no khilaf on this issue. Two Muslim ulama of Ahlul Sunnah don't dispute on this issue. وَإِنْ كَانُوا فَسَقَةً ظَالِمِينَ, even if they are what? Even if they are فُسَاق, فَاسِق, ظَالِم. He's a transgressor. He is a criminal. You can't go against him. This is what? إِجْمَاع. It's a unanimously agreed upon matter. So when you brothers look at Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah, he brought that ijma'. Also Ibn Hajar, he brought the ijma' as well. And others have brought ijma' regarding this issue. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, a statement which is what? Pay attention, brothers. The Prophet's statement, let's analyze it. Illa an taraw, unless you see. So the statement of Imam al-Nawawi is finished. We finished it. So we're now going to analyze the hadith in more details. The Prophet said, illa an taraw, until you see with your eyes. Very good. Kufran, it has to be disbelief. It has to be bawah. Bawah means what? It has to be jaharan. It has to do out in the open. Can't be something which is behind closed doors or... It has to be out. Because the word bawah comes from the what? Baha shay'u yabuhu idha a'lantahu. We took it when we were talking about what? Mubah. The word mubah, when we were studying it, we took the call of Zamakhshari. He said, lam abuhbi. My madhab, I won't bring it out in the open to nobody. Very good. Baha shay'u yabuhu idha a'lantahu. If it's when you make it out in the open. So it has to be out in the open that he does it. And also, what did Allah, the Prophet say? عِنْدَكُمْ مِنَ اللَّهِ فِيهِ بُرْهَانٌ. You have a hujjah which you know from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So there are conditions stipulated to it that you have to see. You have to see it. Not that somebody else saw it for you. Okay, and it has to be clear-cut kufr. Has to be zahir, apparent. And it has to be clear-cut. So it can't be a matter. There is a khilaf amongst Ahlul Sunnah. Is it a kufrun yukhriju min al-millah? Or is it not? Is it a kufr that takes a person out of the Islam? And it can't... None of that. Also, what also falls under it? عندكم من الله في برهان, is that the conditions are all present. توفر الشروط, all the conditions are met. وانتفاء الموانع, and the obstacles that are standing between it is also, such as establishing the proof on him is not there. Now, who is the person who can establish the proof on him? Who is the one who uplifts it from him? Who is the one who can talk about these issues? Again, it has to be a person of knowledge. Because the ayah hadith says what? أَن تَرَوْ كُفْرًا بَوَاحًا عِنْدَكُمْ, to you guys. Who is the عِنْدِي you're talking to? عِنْدَ مَن? To who? Every Bakr, Zayd and Amr. The عِنْدِي here, brothers, is meant by what? It means the people who are those who know the Kitab and they know the Sunnah and they know how to extract rulings from the both of them. Not a person who can't even say his name in Arabic properly. Okay? Or a person who doesn't know the ABCs of the religion. Na'am. Very good. That is very important. Also, the Prophet ﷺ, another hadith. He said, مَنْ رَأَى مِنْ أَمِيرِهِ شَيْئًا. Anyone who sees something from his leader, فَلْيَصْبِرْ, be patient. Be patient. فَإِنَّوْ مَنْ فَارَقَ الْجَمَاعَةِ Anyone who goes against the jama'ah. The jama'ah here is what? It is the leader and the people who is running. All this is Ibn Uthaymeen is bringing this hadith. فَإِنَّوْ مَنْ فَارَقَ الْجَمَاعَةَ شِبْرًا Anyone who goes against the Muslim unity. What's the unity here? It is the Muslim and their leader who they are following. Anyone who tries to cut off from them and he separates himself from them, شِبْرًا even if it's a handspan. And he dies, فَمَاتَ فَمِيتَتُهُ جَاهِلِيَّةٌ His death is a death of pre-Islamic time. It's like the death of a pre-Islamic time. What does it mean that his death is the... What does it mean that his death is the death of a pre-Islamic? What does it mean? It means that the people of the Jahiliyyah before, Ahlul Jahiliyyah, they were upon misguidance. And they never used to have a leader which they used to obey. They never used to obey their leaders. So it means that you as an individual are like those in their action. That you're dying without having on your neck a bay'ah, a pledge of allegiance to your leader. And that statement is benefited from the statement by Ibn Hajar al-Asqalani in Fathul Bari. He said, Al-Muradu bil Ibn Hajar said this. He said, Al-Muradu bil mitatil jahiliyyah. What is meant by that is, وَهِيَ بِكَسْرِ الْمِيمِ He said, we have to put a kasra on the meme. We have to say, فَمِيتَ and not فَمَيْتَ. Very good. بكسر الميمي حالة الموت He said it's the situation of the death كموت أهل الجاهلية Like the death of the pre-Islamic people Which was upon على ضلالة They were upon misguidance وليس لهم إمام مطاع And they never had a leader which they obeyed لأنهم because كانوا لا يعرفون ذلك They never used to recognize that وليس المراد أنه يموت كافرا And the meaning doesn't mean that he dies as a kafir It doesn't mean that بل يموت عاصيا rather he would die as a disobedient individual so brothers inshallah ta'ala observe that statement of Ibn Hajar rahimahullah ta'ala it's powerful also the Shaykh Ibn Uthaymeen brought the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam من خلع يدا anyone who takes his hand back ما معنى خلع يدا he gave bay'ah to the leader and he slips his hand back out من الطاعة from the obedience لقي الله he will meet Allah at the day of judgment لا حجة له he has no proof the Prophet said this alayhi salatu wa sallam The previous hadith that I just mentioned, من رأى من أميره شيئا فليصبر فإنه من فارق الجماعة شبرا فمات فميتته جاهلية The previous hadith was narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. And this hadith is narrated by Imam Muslim. Imam Muslim. من خلع يدا من الطاعة لقي الله يوم القيامة لا حجة له. Anyone who takes his hand from the leader and he meets Allah the day of judgment, he will come and there's no proof for him. The next hadith that Shaykh ibn Uthaymeen rahimahullah brought is a hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah. Imam al-Bukhari, which is that the Prophet said, Isma'u listen, wa ati'u and obey, wa in ummira alaykum abdun habashi. Listen and obey, even if the leadership is passed over to an Abyssinian slave. Because the Arabs wouldn't allow that. They wouldn't allow that. So even if you guys don't like the idea, listen and obey. Listen and obey. وقال عليه الصلاة والسلام and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said على المرء المسلم السمع upon the believing Muslim is to listen and to obey فيما أحب وكره you listen and you obey the leader in that which you like and that which you dislike you still obey him إلا أن يؤمر بمعصية unless he orders you a disobedience فإذا أمر بمعصية if he orders you Disobedience, فَلَا سَمْعَ وَلَا طَاعَ He has no obedience over you and no listening. In that particular matter only. But if he orders you something else which is permissible, you have to still listen to him. The hadith is narrated by Bukhari and Muslim. نعم. And that hadith that I just mentioned, which is the one Ibn Uthaymeen brought, I'm going to mention you in its length, inshallah ta'ala. I'm going to mention to you in its length, because that will allow you to understand it properly. A lot of people try to use this hadith and say, well, we're not going to listen to our leaders because they tell us, they call us disobedience, so they have no obedience over us. Are you with me? And to show you, no, it means that only that matter, you're not allowed to obey him on it. Because once you read the hadith in its full context, you will know it. Imam Muslim narrated it, that Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Ali radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said, Ba'atha Rasulullah, the messenger sent. He sent a group, Sariyah. واستعمل عليهم رجلا من الأنصاري and the Prophet he placed one Ansari man in leadership. Whenever the Prophet used to send a group, he would always make a person in charge. So he made a man in charge of them. And he ordered the others, وَأَمَرَهُمْ أَن يَسْمَعُوا لَهُ وَيُطِيعُوهُ. The Prophet said, this man I've made in charge of you all, when listen and obey him. Listen and obey him. So, فَأَغْضَبُوهُ فِي شَيْءٍ. They angered him. They angered the leader. So when they angered him, فَأَجْمَعُوا لِي حَطَبًا. He said to all of them, bring me sticks. He ordered them, bring me sticks. He said, اجمعوا لي حطبا. Bring for me all sticks. So they brought sticks for him. فأجمعوا له, when they brought them, and then he said, burn a fire. Huh? He told them to light it. And they lit it. فأجمعوا له ثم قال, أوقدوا نارا. فأوقدوا. They lit the fire. And he said to all of them, أَلَمْ يَأْمُرْكُمْ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. Did the messenger not order you to listen to me? And تَسْمَعُوا لِي وَأَن تُطِيعُوا and to obey me? قَالُوا بَلَى. They said, of course. He said, فَأَدْخُلُوهَا. Go into the fire. All of you go into the fire and burn yourselves alive. فَنَظَرَ بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ. Some of them looked at each other. فَقَالُوا إِنَّمَا فَرَرْنَا إِلَى رَسُولِ اللَّهِ مِنَ النَّارِ. They looked at him and they said, we run to the messenger from the fire. We run to the messenger. We ran to the Prophet. فَكَانُوا كَذَلِكَ. And they did so. They ran to the Prophet. His anger went. When they said that, his anger slightly went. وَطُفِئَتِ النَّارُ. The fire was extinguished. When they came back, they told the Prophet what took place. And then the Prophet ﷺ said to them, لَوْ دَخَلُوهَا مَا خَرَجُوا مِنْهَا. If you guys entered it, none of you guys would come out of it. You'll all die. وَإِنَّمَا الطَّاعَةُ فِي الْمَعْرُوفِ. The obedience is placed on what? In good. You obey the leader in that which is good. So it means that the obedience was only, you disobey him in this particular matter. If he orders you a matter which is wrong like that, you don't obey him in it. But anything other than that, you obey him. You still carry on obeying him. Sheikh ibn Uthaymeen goes on to bring more hadith. He brought the hadith of Abdullah ibn Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu. Good. He brings that. وقال عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله تعالى عنهما. عبد الله بن عمر, may Allah be pleased with him and his father. He said, كنا مع النبي, we were with the Prophet. في سفر, on a journey. فنزلنا منزلا, we came to a place. فنادى منادي رسول الله. The caller of the caller of the Prophet called out. The word, somebody called out, the Prophet ordered a person to go and call the people. And this is the way that the Prophet used to call the people. He used to say, As-salat jami'ah. The salah is to come together. Very good. So remember, we have to say, As-salat jami'atan. Why would we say As-salat jami'atan? Because mansubata ala al-hali. Okay? As-salat jami'atan. The salah is jami', come together. Fajtama'na, we came together to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. When we came to the Prophet looked at us and he said to us, إِنَّهُ مَا مِن نَبِيٍ بَعَثَهُ اللَّهُ. Allah did not send a Prophet, إِلَّا كَانَ حَقًّا, except it was obligatory on him and it's a responsibility on him, أَن يَدُلَّ أُمَّتَهُ عَلَى خَيْرِ مَا يَعْلَمُهُ لَهُمْ, for him to show them the good in which he knows for them, وَيُنذِرَهُمْ, and that he warns from them, شَرَّ مَا يَعْلَمُهُ لَهُمْ, the evil that he knows that might harm them, that he warns them of it. So Allah has not sent a prophet except that it was obligatory, it is his mission, is what he has to come with is what? He has to tell his ummah the good that he knows that they can achieve. Take this road, you're going to receive this. And it's upon that prophet as well that he warns them of any evil that he knows that's going to come, that he tells them of it. And then now the prophet tells them. He said, وَإِنَّ أُمَّتَكُمْ هَذِهِ جُعِلَتْ عَافِيَتُهَا فِي أَوَّلِهَا. That this ummah, the cure has been placed in the earliest. The early generations, Allah placed in them the cure. وَسَيُصِيبُ آخِرَهَا بَلَاءٌ وَأُمُورٌ تُنْكِرُونَهَا. And the later generations, there's going to afflict them calamities and matters which they will reject. وَتَجِيءُ فِتْنَةٌ. Trials and tribulations will come. تُرَقِّقُ بَعْضُهَا بَعْضًا. Some of it will soften another. Meaning when one comes, the people will think that the one before was nothing. And then when the other one, that was nothing. Each one would make the other one before it weak. It seems like that wasn't even a problem. Good. تَجِيءُ الْفِتْنَةِ. The trials and the tribulations will come. فيقول المؤمن, the believer will say, هذه مهلكتي, this is my destruction. وتجيء الفتنة, then the trials, another trial and tribulation will come. فيقول, he will say, هذه, هذه, no, this is this one, not the one before, no, this one, this one, this one. Look how the Prophet told us the solution. The Prophet said, فَمَنْ أَحَبَّ, anyone who wants, أَنْ يُزَحْزَحَ عَنِ النَّارِ, anyone who wants to be diverted from the hellfire, وَيُدْخِلَ الْجَنَّةِ, and for him to be put into Jannah, فَلْيَأْتِ مَنِيَّتُهُ, مَنِيَّ means death, let death come to him, فَلْيَأْتِهِ, let it come to him, مَنِيَّتُهُ, let death come to him, وَهُوَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ, let death come to him, whilst he believes in Allah and the Day of Judgment. Let death come to you whilst you believe in Allah and the Day of Judgment. وَلْيَأْتِ إِلَى النَّاسِ, and let him come to the people. And let him come to the people with what? الَّذِي يُحِبُّ أَن يُؤْتَى إِلَيْهِ, and let him come to the people in that which he loves the people to come with him with. Deal with the people in the way you love to be dealt with. And then the Prophet went on to say, وَمَنْ بَايَعَ إِمَامًا, anyone who gives a leader pledge of allegiance, فَأَعْطَاهُ صَفْقَةَ يَدِي, and he gives him his palm, his hand, وَثَمَرَةَ قَلْبِهِ, and he gives him his heart, فَلْيُطِعْهُ, let him obey him, إِنْ إِسْتَطَاعَ, if he's able, فَإِنْ جَاءَهُ آخَرُ, if another person comes, another individual comes, يُنَازِعُهُ, trying to argue with the one that's already in place, another one comes and he wants to take over, فَاضْرِبُ عُنُقَ الْآخَرِ, smack the neck of the second one who wants to take over. رواه إمام مسلم, and إمام مسلم narrated that hadith. إمام مسلم, he narrated that hadith. نعم. والله أعلم, we'll stop there إن شاء الله تعالى for today. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, استغفرك وأتوب إليك.